If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in basic level, where we are in continuation with our discussions in various formulas of inverse trigonometry, and we are seeing some of the typical cases where it differs from our normal trigonometric equations. Okay, then let's see this. Now, if you come to this formula, you can recall 10a plus b. Now you will see there is a symmetry between trigonometry and inverse trigonometry. Okay, can you recall 10a plus b? 10a plus 10b by 1 minus 10a 10b. So same format here. What happens here? This x will become your 10a, y will become your 10b. So you remember this one. So it is something of 10a plus 10b format. So you just give one more. It is 10a plus 10b by 1 minus 10a 10b. So you can think of this 10 is I am bringing here 10 inverse. So a plus b, this is the one angle, this is one angle. So these two angles are added. A plus b equal to 10 inverse of this one. A plus b equal to 10 inverse of this one. And this is x plus y, 1 minus xy. So this is your normal formula. For basic, it is okay. But for advanced and intermediate level, you have to go for one more notion. Why? It is okay if x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0, and xy is less than 1. What is the meaning of xy is less than 1? What happens if xy is less than 1? Then it remains positive. And what happens if xy is greater than 1? Then it becomes negative. Negative means why it is giving negative value. So 10 inverse negative, which one answer it will give? You can recall your 10 inverse. 10 positive, here it gives answer. 10 inverse negative, this quadrant is the answer for 10 inverse negative. So you are adding these two angles, positive angles, and but you are getting negative answer. Why it is giving so? Because whatever angle you are adding, these angles are greater than 45. So if you add, now you can see also xy greater than 1 means, what is x? X is 10 theta equal to x, y is 10 theta equal to y. So what 10.45 gives you? 10.45 gives you 1. Below 45, it is always fraction. So if you multiply two fraction, it will be less than 1, if both are below 45. If both are above 45, then it will be obviously greater than 1, because 45 is 1. That means the angles are, whatever angles you are adding, these two angles, both are greater than 1. Both 10 is greater than 1, 10 of that one. That means both angles are greater than 45. That's why it is greater than 1. Suppose 60. So 60, root 3, it is 3. That's why greater than 1. So if you add two angles which is greater than 45, suppose 60, so it will come to here. It will come here. Second quadrant. But 10 inverse cannot give you second quadrant answer. So 10 inverse giving you this answer in this quadrant. So if you want to move from this quadrant to this quadrant, say the same angle, you want to move it from here to here. Because you know, if you add these two, it will be greater than 90. But it will give you negative answer, because this quadrant is negative value. 10 inverse doesn't go to this quadrant. It will give this quadrant. So this answer, you want to write it in this quadrant. Because actual answer, if you add these two, it will be 120. So if you want to have that actual answer, that's why you have to shift it from here to here. So how to shift from second to fourth? You add pi plus. Second to fourth, you can see this one, pi plus theta. So that's why it is pi plus. Again, 10 inverse x minus 10 inverse y. For difference, it is no okay, not problem, because difference doesn't, if you add, it can go beyond first quadrant, second quadrant, but difference it will be okay. Even if it is negative also, that is also in this or 10 inverse zone only, 10 inverse positive, 10 inverse zone. If you take difference, either it will be plus or minus, which will be here only. So that's why it is okay. Both are positive. Both are positive values. If you take difference, it will be either 0, either for positive value or negative value. So both are in 10 inverse zone. So the answer will be same. Again, same formula, 10a minus 10b by 1 plus 10a 10b. Now sin inverse x plus sin inverse y. So it is sin a plus b. You recall sin a plus b. What was your sin a plus b? You can think of sin a cos b causes sin b. So sin a is x. So if I write only a plus b, so you can take sin inverse that side. What is sin a plus b? Sin a cos b and then causes sin b. Sin a is x and sin b is y. So what will be cos b? If it is y, so 1 minus sin square. If it is x, then what is cos a? 1 minus x square. So it becomes easy for you to remember in that way. Again, x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0, okay. But there is a catch. Again, x square plus y square equal to less than equal to 1. Why it is so? If you don't give x square plus y square equal to 1, if you see what is sin 45. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2 cos. So if you give both 45, then it is exactly 1. So if it is less than 1, that means both the angles are less than 45. Now if you give x square plus y square is greater than 1, that means the angles are not 45. If it is 45, then it is equal to. That means if 1 is at 45, then another would be must be greater than 45. So they are more than 45. That's why their addition is greater than 1. Okay, if it is greater than 1, you can see here also, if So that means they are going in another quadrant. Which quadrant they are going? Greater than 1. If you add both are greater than 45, then it will go to second quadrant. Because if you add 245 like this, 60 plus 60, so it is coming here. Okay, so it is giving answer. But what is your answer? It should come here. But if you do this one, sine inverse will give you what is the answer, sine inverse. Here it is not negative. Here it is all positives. So if you do this one, so sine will give you positive answer. So it is a giving answer here. Sine positive is this quadrant, sine inverse positive is this quadrant, sine inverse negative is this quadrant. If you add 60 plus 60, 120, what is sine 120? Positive. So it will give you positive answer. But actual answer is here. This is your actual answer because 60 plus 60, 120, it should come here if you add these two. So how to shift from this to this quadrant? First to second, it is pi minus theta. If it is theta, then it is pi minus theta. I have already shown you. So that's why it is pi minus this one. Similarly, minus, there is no problem. Sine A minus B, sine A cos B, minus cos A sine B. So that is okay. In terms of cos, there is no problem in formula. Cos A cos B, cos A cos B. If it is plus, then minus sine A sine B. If it is minus, cos A cos B, plus sine A sine B. Cos A cos B, this is cos A, this is cos B. Sine will be under root 1 minus cos square, 1 minus sine B will be 1 minus cos B square, cos square B. Okay, but there is no problem here. Because why there is no problem? Because cos, if you cos is this and this. Even if you add also, if it comes here also, there is no problem because it is inside the cos. Cos will give you the same answer. Cos inverse output is these two quadrants. So it will give, it can give this quadrant as output. If it is, if you are adding these two, if it is coming here also. But sine, if you add these two, it will here, it will not give this output because sine gives output here and here only. So if this is tan A plus B plus C, tan inverse tan A plus tan B plus tan C by tan and ABC, 1 minus tan A, tan B, tan B, tan C, tan C, tan A, like this one. Again, the same idea. If they are, this is less than 1, then this, that they are at first quadrant, all are less than 30. So if you add these three also, that will be in first quadrant. So that's why it is given. And one more notion you can there, if these two are 0, then it is 0. So x plus y plus z is equal to, the sum of three angles cannot be 0, so it will be 180 because tan 0 is also 0, tan 180 is also 0, so it is 180. It can give you either 0 or 180, but 0 I am not writing because three angle sum cannot be 0. That means all three are 0. If they are all non, it is given, it is greater than 0. And if this is equal to, lower portion is 0, then it is pi by 2. Sum of these three is equal to, because then it becomes infinite, 1090 is undefined. Again, this formula, this is for basic one, it is okay. You can remember sine 2 theta in terms of 10. Sine in terms of, so 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan theta, 1 minus 10 square by 1 plus 10 square. This is, actually you can take cos that side and you can think of you are writing cos 2 theta, cos 2 theta in terms of 10, sine 2 theta in terms of 10, tan 2 theta in terms of 10. You remember that, that is okay. Now sine 2x by 1 plus x square is equal to 2 tan inverse x, that is okay if your mod x is less than 1. Okay, so if you see, if it is greater than 1, if it is greater than 1, then tan inverse x is greater than 45, so 2 tan inverse x, 2 tan inverses will give you in second quadrant answer. But sine cannot take second quadrant answer, okay, so it is coming here. If I don't write pi minus this, if I do this one only, and if your x is greater than 1, so x is greater than 1, that means tan inverse will give you something 60 degree, 70 degree answer, which is greater than 1. So 2 of that one will give you in second quadrant. But sine inverse, this is sine inverse, so sine inverse will not give you that answer. So if you want to equate it to sine inverse, what this is your, for sine inverse this is positive. So for in second quadrant, sine inverse what it will give? It will give positive answers here. Because sine inverse positive is this quadrant, it, not in this quadrant. So it will give answer here. So if you want to make, you are landing it here, 2 tan inverse x is here. You want to write it in sine inverse, so you have to come back to here. So how to come back from second quadrant to first quadrant? It is pi minus theta, I have already shown you. This is second to first or first to second, it is pi minus theta. So that's why it is pi minus 2 tan inverse x. Now if its value is less than minus 1, less than minus 1, that means you are going less than minus 45. So now if you multiply 2, if I just write 2 tan inverse x, it will come here now. 2 tan inverse x. Because less than 45, suppose less than 45 is minus 60. So minus 60 2 times minus 180. Your answer is here. But sine negative answer is here. This answer is okay, sine negative, this is here means sine will give you negative, but sine inverse will not give you this answer. For negative value, sine inverse will give you this answer. From here to here, if you want to come. So I have not shown you to how to come from this to this. But you can think it in this way also. So whatever these angles, the same angle should be here. So this is 2 tan inverse x. So So if you add with pi, so you will get this angle. What will be this angle? Negative of this is this one. So what is this one? This is pi plus 2 tan inverse x. Because 2 tan inverse x, then if you add pi, because 2 tan inverse x will give you some negative value, minus, suppose it is, let me take minus 121 example. So what is this angle? 180 plus minus 120. So this is 60 degree. But your answer should be, this angle should come here. So it is minus 60 degree. So minus of this angle. So minus of pi plus 2 tan inverse x. If you want to move from this to this curve. So this typical formulas will be required for advanced level. For basic level, you just remember this formula, what I have given in the box. That's okay. Similarly, you can come from this also, cos inverse. Again, this one is this. For positive, it is okay. For less than 0, 2 tan inverse x is here. So here, what is the value? Cos positive. For positive value, it doesn't, cos doesn't give this answer. Cos give this quadrant. So you want to shift from this to this. So what will be the shifting? That is minus. From 4 to 7 minus. Because here, cos is positive. But cos doesn't give this quadrant answer, cos give this quadrant, so you have to shift it to this quadrant, that's it. Again, tan, for tan it is okay. 2 tan inverse x, if both the angles is less than 45, then it's done. If you see, if your angle goes less than minus 1, that means you are going to which quadrant? This quadrant. 2 tan inverse x is here now, because less than minus 1 means less than 60, it will go, come to this quadrant. So here, what is the value of tan? Tan value is positive, but tan positive doesn't give answer, so it gives answer here. So you have to come here. So these angles are okay. You just add 45. You just add pi. So it will rotate 180 degree because it is the same line. So you shift it by 180 degree, then it will come here. Now if it is greater than 1, that means you are coming at this quadrant. 2 tan inverse x is here. So here tan value is negative. But tan inverse doesn't give negative here. Tan inverse give negative here. So you have to come here. Now if you have to come here, you have to come back. Clockwise movement is positive movement. So that's why you are adding. Anti-clockwise is always positive. Now you are moving clockwise, you are coming back. You are not moving this side, you are moving this side. So it should pi minus pi. So 2 tan inverse x minus pi. You can write it in this format or this format. I thought this will be okay, easy for understand to go this way.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.